Ichi-ni-san. Ohayo. Minasan ohayo gozaimasu. Watashi no kurasu. O hisashiburi desu. O genki desu ka? Watashi mo genki dakara. Genki dakara. Yokoso. Recha no burugu. Nihongo no kurasu. Nihongo no kurasu. Anata wa kiku jimbu ga dekite masu ka? Tottemo yoi. Kono mae, watashi mo YouTube channel o kodoku suru koto o wasurenai de kudasai. Onegai. Onegai shimasu. Kodoku suru koto o wasurenai de kudasai. Okay, before good morning everyone. So this is Lecture Vlog. Kasama ang inyong lingkod na si Sir Jade. So this is Japanese class. Again, as I said, i-subscribe nyo po yung channel ko. Yun ang sinabi ko sa uli. All right. Now let's discuss a new topic regarding in Japanese. Okay, which is evento no chumon. So this is evento no chumon. Okay, so how to use sentence patterns ordering event on a time scale. So that is evento no chumon. Okay? So are you ready? So learning objectives, discuss how to use madini by in Japanese sentence. Explain how to use sentence patterns ordering events on a time scale and give examples of sentence pattern ordering events. Now, let's discuss now. So let's discuss what is madini. Madini. No? So when you talk about madini in Japanese, it is the combination of the particles made and ni. This is combined of two, madini. Marks the time limit. Kumbaga, ito yung gagawin mo in the future, by or before. So ito pong ginagamit na suffix or particle in the Japanese sentence po, no, which is part of the sentence. I'm going to give examples, okay? Example. I will submit my report by tomorrow. So the answer in Japanese, Ashita made ni reputo deshimasu. So meaning first, the first rule here, the adverbs of time, no? Adverbs of time muna. Adverbs of time and then followed by the particle madini, no? Madini. And then ano yung gagawin? Ano yung bagay na gagawin? Ano yung bagay na gagawin, which is example report, 'di ba? Yun yung isasubmit, 'di ba? So rep ano muna yung yun yung ginagagawin eh. So yun yung magiging subject. So repoto, no? Report. Repoto, that is katakana word repoto, o dashimasu. I will submit my report. So the verb is dashimasu. Okay? O dashimasu. Kasi I will submit pa lang. So I said, kapag future, ano pa rin? Ang kanyang conjugation still in the mass form pa rin. In the mass form. Okay? So again, I will submit my report by tomorrow. Ashitama dini. Repoto dashimasu. Ashitama dini repoto deshimasu. And then this one is I will come back before 4 o'clock, no? I will come back before 4 o'clock. So first, puta tayo dun muna sa time. Adverbs of time. So the time is 4 o'clock. So yoji madini. So that is particle madini. Modo rimasu. I will come back. Modo rimasu. All right. Okay. So, are you ready for the next example? Very good. So, Raybun, let's try to answer this Japanese sentence. No? Sige. Based dun sa sinabi ko, ha, dapat unahin mo na yung adverbs of time. And then, kung ano yung after that, madini. And then, yung object. And then the verb, that is the rule, no? Or naim mo naman yung adverbs of time, palabip madini, the object, and then the conjugation of verb. So example, I will discuss my agenda by Saturday morning. Uy, nawala. Sorry. Nawala. Let's go back, no? Yan, para mas maganda. Ayan, I will discuss my agenda by Saturday morning. Okay, so again, what is Saturday morning muna? What is Saturday morning? So, Saturday morning, it's hiragana word, right? Hiragana word. Ayaw mag-ano. Alright, wait. Chotomate. Yan. Do, yo, B. And do you be? Do you be? Do you be? No. Asa? That is Saturday morning, no? Do you be no asa? Tama, asa? Do you be no asa? Madini? Ma? De? Ni? Madini. Do you be no asa? Madini. Giday. Agenda is giday. So that is still hiragana word. Giday o. So what is the word I will discuss? So discuss is Hanashi aimasu. Hanashi aimasu. All right. So do you be no asa? Madini. Giday o anashi aimasu. Okay? Do you be no asa madini? Giday o hanashimasu. Next. Again, it is do you be no asa madini? Giday o hanashimasu. Okay, para naman po sa mga nahihirapan, iro-romaji ko na. And do you be no asa madini giday o anashi aimasu. So that is the translation of I will discuss my agenda by Saturday morning. Next, try to answer this in the comment section. I will take my midterm exam by next week. And I will take my midterm exam by next week. So first, next week muna. Okay. Raishu. Madini. Raishu madini chukan. Again, chukan. Ah, ano lang tayo, iragana lang. Chukan chicken. chicken chicken. Yan, chicken chicken. So pag sa amin na chicken chicken. Chicken chicken o okemas. O okay. Mas, yan. So that is Raishu Madini. Chicken chicken. Okemas. So that is number two. I will take my midterm exam by next week. Raishu Madini. Chicken chicken. Okemas. And then I will go home before 5 p.m. So 5 p.m. is go gym. Madeni. Pwede ng e or pwede ring ni. I-E-N-I. Kaerimas. As I will go home. Kaerimas. Ulit. Kaerimas. Yan. So, yan. Gojimadeni. Ni kae rimas. Yeah. So that is the example, no? Based on Madini. So yan, number one, I will discuss my agenda by Saturday morning. Dayo bino asa Madini kiday o nashimas. Anashiyaimas. I will take my midterm exam by next week. Raishu Madini. Chicken o okemas. And I will go home before 5 p.m. Goguji Madini. Ie ni kae imas. So that is the first part. Next one. Sentence patterns ordering events on a time scale. Some sentence patterns are used to order events on a time scale. Here we'll study 5 such sentence. Example po, A, te, kara, B. So, kumbaga, yung verb in a form of te form. Te form, remember? Example, tabiru. Instead of tabiru, magiging tabete. Oshiru, magiging oshiete. Example, nomiru. Teko dasay, magiging nonde. Okay? Teko dasay ang tawag doon. So, as you remember, normally, ginagamit yun, di ba? Ginagamit yun sa mga kodasay. But this time, gagamitin din natin siya in this form of sentence. Na yung tekarabi connects a sequence of events, A and B, with an immediate preceding the main event. So example, here, I will go to work at my part-time job after eating lunch. Ang technique dito yung after. So after yung gagawin yun. Example, I will go to work at part-time job after eating lunch. So eating lunch first, you need that is yun muna kasi after eating lunch ano muna yung gagawin mo ba after no after mo gawin yung isang bagay so yung after so after eating lunch ano muna yung gagawin mo after eating lunch di ba so pagkatapos mo gawin yung isang bagay yun yung ibig ko sabihin so example di ba gagawin mo dito ka ano muna pagkatapos mo kumain magtatrabaho ka na sa part-time mo. So, eating lunch mo, di ba? Kakain ka muna ng lunch. So, eating lunch, it's hiruguhan o tabete. Lunch is hiruguhan. Hiruguhan o tabete. Eating eh. Kara. Aro ba ito eh? Ikimas. Ibig sabihin, I will go to work at my part-time job. That is aro ba ito agad yun. Part-time job. Aro ba ito eh? ikimasu. And then after jogging, I took a shower. So here, after, so anong ba yung after ng after muna sa, di ba? After, that is jogging. So jogingu oshitekara. Jogingu oshitekara. Oh, shower, shawa, o aso abimashita. So actually, combining ito eh, ng two sentence na pinag-combine. Ang tumutuloy yung after lunch, yung after. So after jogging, I took a shower. So, jogingu oshitekara. Shawa, o abimashita. Okay? So, ribun. Example, I will visit the museum after teaching history class. So, if you know the answer, please comment below. Okay? If you know the answer, please comment below. Okay, so let's try to answer this, no? So, first, I will visit the museum after teaching history class. So, after teaching muna tayo, after teaching history class. So, history class is Rekishi no Kurasu. Rekishi is Sirgohan, right? Rekishi is Hiragana word. Rekishi no and Rekishi combined two words to. Rekishi and tayo. Rekishi no. So, yung kurasu, it is katakana word, right? Kurasu. Oh, sorry. Katakana. Kurasu. Kurasu. Kurasu and then kurasu oh what is sorry and oh oshiete teach to teach is oshieru oshiete oshiete kara museum is hakubutsukan hakubutsukan Aku butsukan eh kasi pupunta eh visit eh ikimasu. All right. So again, rekishi no kurasu. Rekishi no kurasu. Rekishi no kurasu. Oshiete. Madini. Kara madini kara hakubutsukan ikimasu. Okay, so that is number one. Next example, after dating with Maki Ito, I wrote a love letter. So if you want to know the answer, please write your answer in the comment section. Try to answer. Alright. Tatemo yoi. Very good. So, technique muna here. Ito Maki. Ito Maki. Ito Maki. Sama natin. Ito Maki to. Oto Maki to. Suki ata. Suki ata. Sama. Suki ata. Double T. Suki ata. Nochi. Nochi. Okay. No. Chi. Ochi. O. 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 Shite. O. Shite. 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 Kara. Kara. Next mong gagawin, I wrote. So, rabur, this is love letter, raburata, rabureta. So, this is katakana word, right? Katakana. Rabu. Rabu. Re. Ta. Yan. Rabu reta. O. Rabu reta. O. Kakimashita. Yan. Rabureta o kakimashita. Okay, para sa mga hindi maintindi. So, ito maki. Ito maki. To. Ito maki to. Ito maki to. Suki ata. Suki. Suki ata. Suki ata. Nochi. Nochi kara. Nochi kara. Rabu reta o kakimashita. So that is after dating with Makito, I wrote a love letter. So that is the second example. So if you have some questions, don't hesitate to ask me. Shitsu manuari masuka? So comment below. Okay, I'm going to answer that later. I'm going to answer that. Okay, so next is yan. Pay attention to the verb form before kara. If a tense form is used before kara, it is a different construction and stands for a reason. Example, before I went jogging, I took a shower. So since ganun pa rin naman. So, before I went jogging, I took a shower. So, ganun pa rin. Jogging o shita kara. Jogging o shita kara. So, ang magagawin, because I went, ang mangyayari po, gagamit yung magiging, ano nyo, yung magiging, yung verb, magiging ta, instead of te, ta. Jogging o shita kara shawa o asibimashita. Because I went. So, magiging shita. Jogging o shita, karashawa o asi sabimashita. Ah, sorry. Jogging o shita, karashawa o abimashita. Puyat lang. Antok. Jogging o shita, karashawa o abimashita. Okay. Ato de, B or B after A. So, ato, a non-literal meaning space behind. So, that is space behind. It is used in the sense of time after, just like any noun, it can be modified by either another noun or modifying clause. If a modifying noun is used, the connecting particles no must appear between the modifier noun and ato. Example, after lunch. Hiruguhan no ato de. Hiruguhan no ato de. After lunch. Yan. In modifying clause is used, it must always be in the plain past form. So plain past form lang tayo. Okay, on the main clause tense. Okay, so example, hiruguhan o tabeta ato de after we eat or ate lunch. That is, hiruguhan o tabeta ato de. Okay, hiruguhan o tabeta ato de eiga omimasu. Ibig sabihin, after we eat lunch, we will see a movie. Eiga omimasu. Okay, so ito, after we eat lunch, we saw a movie. Here are some examples. Yan. Hiruguhan o tabeta ato de eiga omimashita. So yung here are some examples, nadagdag lang po, hindi po yung kasama sa sentence, ha? After we eat lunch, we saw a movie lang. Yun lang po, yun na po, nasama. Yung here are some examples. So hindi po yung kasama. Okay? Hindi po yan kasama. Putulin natin, baka sabihin na nasama lang. Yan. Ayan, padagdag na natin to. Ayan. Yan. Yan, nasama lang, nasama lang. Ayun, let's go back. So again, after we eat lunch, after we eat or eat lunch, hiruguhan o tabeta ato de. After we eat lunch, we'll see a movie. So hiruguhan o tabeta after we eat lunch, di ba? Hiruguhan o tabeta ato de eiga omimasu. Next is after we eat lunch, we saw a movie. Hiruguhan o tabeta ato de eiga omimashita. So, ang rules dito, yung verb, gagawin nyo pa rin top form, ha? Top form in this type of sentence. Example, here are some more examples. Example, I had lunch after the class. I had lunch after the class. So, dito, after the class, so, jugyo no. So, after the class, so, that is jugyo no ato de. Jugyo no ato de. Hiruguhan o tabe mashita. So after the summer break is over, I will go back to Europe. So summer break is over. It's natsuyasumi. Gawata. Ato de. And then I will go back to Europe. Yorapa e kaeremas. I will go back kaeremas. Yorapa. Europe. Yorapa. Yorapa. E kaeremas. And then like it. Te, kara B, the pattern A, ato de, B, describes a sequence of events where the subordinate event A is followed by the main event B. However, while A, te, kara refers to the span of time immediately after A. So, yung at A, ato de, refers to some span after A. Hence, the while te, kara be used in the sentence of since ato de kanat. So, example, here, you know, it has been 3 years since I came to Japan. Kasi yung since nga, or because, pwede rin in a form of, ano din yun, in a form of, pwede rin in a form of kara, because, kara, or it is form of, ato de. Example, it has been 3 years since I came to Japan. Nihon ni, kite, kara sanen des. Or yung ibang form niya, pwedeng ganito. It has been 3 years after I came to Japan. Pag after na po, instead of kite, magiging kita. Nihon no kita. Ato de. Sanen des. 3 years. Sanen des. Oh. And then, pag ano naman, pag before, it's mae. So, that is adverb of time. Mae. So, mae, a non-literal meaning space in front. It's all used in same sense of time before and can be modified by a noun or a sentence. So, the modifier noun must be followed by particle no. Example, bango no mae ni. Dinner is banggohan. Banggohan no maini. Before dinner. So, ito mga example. Plain form lang. So, before we eat or eat dinner, banggohan o taberu maini. So, banggohan o taberu before we eat dinner or eat dinner. Banggohan o taberu maini. So, I will study before eating dinner. So, banggohan o taberu maini. Then, yung I will study, benkyo shimasu. Benkyo shimasu. And then I studied before eating dinner. So mangyayari, ganun pa rin, bangkuan o tabi rumain eh. And then I studied benkyo shimashita. Shimashita, that is past tense. Okay, and then these are more examples. So you can specify how long in advance of the modifying event the main event takes place by adding a duration word before mae. So I checked my notebook once more 30 minutes before the test started. Test started is test 2, gahaji maru. 30 minutes sa jupon mae ni mo ichido noto o mimashita. So I checked my book, no? I check my book, no? Once more. So, mo ichido no to. Mo ichido no to. Omimashita. So, dito, unahin mo na yung test to. And then, test started. Kailan ba nag-started? So, test to, 30 minutes before, di ba? O more before, more 30 minutes before. So, test to, gahajimaru. 30 minutes, sanju po, before maini. Ayan, I check my book once more. Mu ichido noto o checking is mimashita. And then next one is I went the graduation ceremony was a month before I went to Paris. Example, Paris is pare ni iku. I went to Paris no pare ni iku ikagetsu mai ni, that is month before. Pare ni ikagetsu mai ni month, no? Oh, graduation ceremony sotsugyo shiki ga arimashita. So these are the other suffix na ginagamitan po ng chu. When you talk about chu, in the middle of, in the middle of, for example, on the phone, then what chu? In the middle of the meeting, kaigi chu, that is kaigi meeting. In the middle of studying, benkyo chu. So, basta pag middle na, chu ang ginagamit. At work, shigoto chu. In the middle of a class, jugyo chu. Jugyo chu. Of an office, home, etc. Geishutsu chu. In the middle of a meal, shokuji chu. In use, shiyo chu. In the middle of an exam, tesuto chu. On a diet, diet to chu. In the middle of a download, they yun ron to chu. So those are chu na pwedeng gamitin. Basta in the middle of, or on the phone, or at work, pwedeng gamitin yung chu. For example, Professor Saito is in class right now. Sabihin na sa middle siya ng klase si Professor Saito. Saito sensei wa ima right now. Ima jugyuchu des. Jugyuchu des. Kasi nasa klase, nasa kalagitnaan ng klase. Professor Saito is in class right now. Saito sensei wa ima jugyuchu des. Example, during meals. Chukujichu. Chukujichu wa terebi omimasen. I don't watch TV during meals. Chukujichu wa terebi omimasen. The exam is going until 2 o'clock. So, 2 o'clock, niji, made. Kasi, made, ang gagamitin made. Made, tas to, chu, des. It's going eh. Diba? Going pa lang eh. Niji, made. Niji, made. Tas to, chu, des. And then, pag toki ni, when. Toki and non-literal meaning time can be used a modifying clause in the sense of when. When, siya na. At the time, when, since the toki is a noun, its modifier follow the basic noun's modification patterns. Example, while a student. So, while a student. So, gakusei no toki ni. Example, when I'm busy, isugashi toki ni. When it is hard, taihen na toki ni. When I read book, hon uyomu toki ni. So, example ah. Ginagamitan na to kayo. Pag when yun, kung kailan may ginagawa ka, ganun, when I reading, when I eat, you know, toki ni. For example, my elder sister studied abroad when she was high school student. No? So, aniwa, kukose, no, toki ni, ryugaku, shimashita. Yan. Ane wa kokose no toki ni yugaku shimashita. Yung nag-aaral pa siya nung high school. Pumunta siya ng abroad nung pumunta siya ng high school. Ito. Take the test. Tesuto no toki ni jishu ga irimasu ka. So, kung kailan we will need the dictionary when we take test. So, jishu, that is dictionary. Jishu ga irimasu ka. Pag kailangan ng dictionary, irimasu ka. Okay? So, ganun lang kadali itong toki ni. And then, I use glasses when I look at the blackboard. So, blackboard is kokuban o miru. Toki ni. Megane otsukaimasu. Okay? So, toki ni. Megane otsukaimasu. So, if you have some more questions, don't hesitate to ask me. So, by commenting below. Okay? So, how to use yung mga different event na chumbo. Or yung paano ba ginagamit yung mga yung adverbs of time, yung mga before, yung mga toki ni, and so on. So, mas maganda magbigay kayo ng mga iba pang mga examples by applying those type of suffix in this type of sentence. So, I hope you learn a lot. May mga natutunan kayo. This is just a short discussion regarding ibento ni Chumon. So, domo arigato gozaimasu. Watashi no kurasu. Kyotsukete. Kyotsukete. Jau mata. Ingat, ingat. Thank you for listening.